which are the best, most accurate glucose meters for diabetics to use for blood sugar control? Do the cheapest meters and test strips perform well? The FDA has now changed the standards and tightened up regulations, so we will cover some of the new independent studies done to confirm which brands meet expectations. And it is not good news at all. Actually, it's shocking if you ask me, because I bet the meter you're probably using right now failed that test. So today, I will also show you how to test your own meter to determine how exact and error-free it may be. But before we begin, let me welcome all of you resilient diabetics out there. This is the channel we turn ordinary, struggling diabetics into extraordinarily well-controlled diabetics. If you don't know who I am and you are brand new to this channel, I welcome you. My name is Jay Sampat, and I became an insulin-dependent diabetic a little over 6 years ago due to an autoimmune attack which caused the destruction of my pancreas due to a severe gluten allergy response. So basically, I am the proud owner of a pancreas that's gone on a permanent and lifelong vacation. So not only am I a diabetic just like you, where we will be walking that walk and talking that talk together, but I do also have a University of Bachelor of Science degree in nutrition dietetics, and that does come in handy in helping discuss all the intricacies of being a diabetic. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button followed by the gray notification bell, then choose turn on all notifications if you want to be notified when a Resilient Diabetic video has been published. As with all of my videos, this should not be considered personal medical advice. This is my interpretation of the latest research. If you want medical advice, please always consult your doctor. Monitoring our blood sugar or blood glucose is extremely important for many of us diabetics. And in order to avoid all the horrific complications that come with this disease, it becomes an absolute requirement. The further my understanding of diabetes, the more I have realized not all glucose meters were and are created equal. I was initially fine with the discrepancies my meter displayed. I thought, you know what, it wasn't a big deal. But over time, as I've progressed, I've needed tighter and tighter control, thus more accuracy from this very, very important tool. This is especially true if one wants to keep their A1C in those non-diabetic ranges. It is even more critical for those of us complicated insulin-dependent diabetics like myself on multiple insulins like a bolus and a basal insulin. The wrong readings equates to mismanagement. One false reading means either too much insulin or not enough, throwing off the entire day's sequence of events. The diabetic community has been pounding the table and screaming when it comes to the wild variations many of these meters give. Having a reliable glucose meter can make your life so much easier and help you get right on track with diet, with exercise, and the treatment plan. If you are a newly diagnosed diabetic, you are going to have a myriad of choices when it comes to that glucose meter, and it can become both overwhelming and highly confusing, especially if you have to go out in the marketplace and buy one for yourself. Which ones do you get? Should it be based on the price of the meter or the price of the strips? The accuracy of the meter? How much blood will the meter require? What about the size and the ease of execution of the meter? How about one of those really new cool smartphone readers? One out of every three adults here in the United States is now pre-diabetic, and this trend is growing, and it will only get worse. Why is this just the tip of the iceberg? Well, here's a funny story for you. Just yesterday, I had an appointment with my diabetic endocrinologist and the RN, actually to confirm whether or not I would qualify for a prescription for a continuous glucose monitor. As I was leaving the meeting, I actually ended up taking the elevator down, and this is what I saw in the lobby of the hospital right when the elevator opened. A cart full of nothing but highly dense, sugar-based snacks and junk food. Imagine every newly diagnosed diabetic in shock, just leaving the same doctor's offices whose world has just been turned upside down with the news. Carbohydrates are killing you. And in order to fight this really complicated disease, you're going to have to change your diet and lifestyle. Then seize this right when they exit the elevator door. And let me remind you, this is in the lobby of the hospital specifically treating diabetes. If you're brand new to this channel, I will set up a video in both the description box below and at the end of this video called How Long Can You Live with Diabetes? I will cover all the hurdles and the brick walls you may face as a diabetic, and most importantly, how one removes all the noise and the clutter so that you are put on the right path from day one. You will not only grasp the mistakes our institutions are making, but why this is leading to an area of diabetic supplies becoming a multi-billion dollar market and growing. It is a highly competitive market with new players coming in all the time, all wanting a piece of that burgeoning pie. Diabetes, as you have to remember, is a worldwide epidemic. By 2021, the global market for blood glucose strips alone will be worth an estimated $13 billion. Global sales of diabetic drugs will also reach a record of around $121 billion. If you think everyone wants to play nice in this competitive field, you are highly mistaken. So you decide to do a Google search for the best glucose meter. What you may not know is that many of the top positions are actually paid and bought off advertisements, pushing their brand as the very best over their competitors. And here's what I want to warn you. Those second sets of positions are also highly manipulated too. As you will find out, certain glucose meters work best in certain blood sugar ranges, and the manufacturers know this. So unbeknownst to you, they will set up tests where their meters are put up against others at ranges they do not perform well at. So basically, they are also glorified paid for commercials as they push their meter as the best. For someone like myself, when I was first diagnosed, I was actually given a meter by my health insurance and I never questioned its accuracy. I figured as a large health-based institution, they know what is best for me. Plus, my strips are covered for a discount, so why would I go out and pay full price for these really expensive test strips? So then this begs, who do we trust? Which meters serve us better? And here is the first problem. The FDA is currently reviewing and updating the guidelines for glucose meter accuracy. The 2016 rules called for a plus or minus 20% accuracy for most blood sugar ranges. Many diabetic advocacy groups appealed back to the FDA demanding better accuracy because treatment decisions are based on these readings and can dramatically improve or impact outcomes. So unfortunately, these new revised rules issued in 2016 applied to new products only and did not impact meters and strips already on the market. So while these new, tighter accuracy requirements were positive changes, we still have to keep in mind that a lot of these less accurate meters are and still out on the markets and in the hands of us diabetics. The new 2019 FDA drafted rules for personal glucose meters will require a 95% within plus or minus 15% across the measuring range, or a 99% within plus or minus 20% across the measuring range. The second issue, it was assumed that glucose meters are accurate if they were FDA cleared, but often that is not the case. All of the meters do require FDA clearance at some point, but the FDA only looks at their company reported trials when it reviews their meters. Where have the independent studies been? Well, the good news, these independent studies are now available And I liked what they did. They actually purchased these meters directly through the retailers and then tested them rigorously at their research centers. In a triple blinded multi-site independent study done by the Diabetes Technology Society Blood Glucose System Surveillance Program, also known as DTS, researchers found that only 1/3 of the commercially available FDA-cleared glucose meters here in the United States could consistently perform to an accuracy standard set by the FDA. Out of the 18 blood glucose monitors tested, only 6 were consistently accurate in each one of their 3 sites. 5 were compliant in 2 out of 3 sites, 3 in just 1, and 4 failed in all 3 sites. And what did the test show? The best performing meter was called the Contour Next, which was accurate 100% of the time at 2 sites and 99% of the time at the 3rd. The other 5 consistently accurate meters were the Roche AccuCheck Aviva Plus, the AccuCheck SmartView, Walmart's Relion Confirm Micro, CVS's Advanced Glucose Meter, and Abbott's Freestyle Lite. But be warned, some of the same manufacturers from the same outlet with 2 different models will have a pass and a fail rating. Be sure you know which exact model passed and which model failed. What was the disheartening blow? The best sellers and the ones that have the most market share were the ones that tended to be the least accurate. What was also troubling in the other clinical trials? Researchers noted an unusual reporting pattern of blood glucose data. Their results indicated a clear bias towards elevated values for blood glucose levels. These observations are deeply concerning with regards to our safety, since overestimation of blood glucose may result in false perception of real glycemic control. I will add a link for all the studies below in the description box for you to review each one in detail. So the question begs, what would be a great overall meter if one were to choose? And there are 2 more problems. First, what is your target A1C set by your doctor? So in other words, if your doctor wants you to have blood sugars in the 90 to 180 range, one set of meters generally works best in that range. If your doctor wants you low and controlled with an A1C in the non-diabetic range at all times, then only a few meters are capable of really accurate readings in that 70 to 99 milligram range. And most importantly, how would you test the accuracy of the meter that you have? You can get a rough idea of the precision of any meter by performing 4 blood glucose measurements in succession. They should be within 5% of one another when blood sugars are in the 70 to 120 milligram range. Based on the doctors who want all their diabetic patients to be in the non-diabetic range, including their type 1 diabetics, then the consensus is the Abbott's Freestyle Lite and the Freestyle Freedom are some of the best. Depending on where you are and whether you can get them covered, the downside may be they may not be the cheapest option. Couple of very important notes when it comes to getting that really accurate reading. It may not be the fault of your meter, but your technique. Anything you touch or put on your skin can end up in the blood sample and then on your test strip. Since many current meters utilize a micro-sized blood sample, just touching something that contains sugar or not washing your hands properly can affect the readings. If you recently washed your hands but you did not dry them completely, the water left on your fingers can have a diluting effect on the sample as well. In the comment section below, I would love to know which glucose meters do you use. Would you recommend that glucose meter to a brand new diabetic? What features in particular do you like or hate? And how often, by the way, do you actually check your blood sugar levels? If you're on a desktop or laptop, use that mouse to click this upcoming box. If you're on your mobile device, just tap that with your fingers. The first is the link to subscribe to this all-important channel. The second is the link to the playlist mentioned on diabetes care. So have a great and productive day, and we will see you soon with another new episode. Like I said, are generally released weekly. Bye for now.